Hello and welcome to the episode 66 of What A Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, among other things, we'll talk about the Beatles' first radio session, a Brian Epstein marketing experiment, and a lovely recording session. On the 7th of March 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, were engaged at the Cassanova Club in Liverpool. In 1962, the Beatles, still featuring Pete Best on drums, wore suit and tie for the first time during a public engagement. The grey suits of brushed tweed, along with the ties, cost them £160, about £3,440 in 2020 money, and signalled the end of the rough looks of the band with their leather jackets and jeans. The lads had fought a bit over it with their new manager Brian Epstein, but they decided to listen to him in the end. After all, if wearing suits meant having more prestigious and better paid gigs, including some outside Liverpool, this was a price worth paying. The occasion to show the change of look was a prestigious one. The band's first recordings for BBC at the Playhouse Theatre in Manchester. The Beatles rehearsed their performance at 3:45 p.m. and then went on recording the whole Teenager Stern, Here We Go show with other artists, Brian Newman, the Trad Lads, and the Northern Dance Orchestra directed by Bernard Herrmann. The recording took place from 8 p.m. to 8:45 p.m. live in front of a live audience of teenagers. For the occasion, the Beatles performed three covers, Dream Baby, How Long Must I Dream, Memphis, Tennessee, and Please Mr. Postman. The Teenager Stern show was broadcast nationally on the 8th of March between 5 and 5:29 p.m. In 1963, we have the first occurrence of what would become known as the Mersey Beat Showcase Tour, another marketing idea by Brian Epstein, perhaps inspired by the early Motown Records reviews. Five acts from Liverpool, the Beatles, Jerry and the Pacemakers, the Big Three, Billy J. Kramer and the Dakotas, and Bob Wooler, travel today on two NEMS Enterprise buses from Liverpool to the Elizabeth Ballroom in Nottingham for a night of entertainment. 80 fans joined the bands and their crews from Liverpool, paying an all-inclusive price of 25 shillings, about £26 in 2020 money. There were to be another five such engagements in the next 3 months. On the 7th of March 1965, the Beatles shot footage for their Help feature film in New Providence, Bahamas. Today, they filmed the temple scene in a location which was actually a hospital for handicapped children and old people, a place whose very poor conditions disgusted the band. In 1967, the Beatles were again at the EMI studios to record some overdubs onto Lovely Rita. Between 7 p.m. and 2:30 a.m., the band recorded vocal harmonies and other effects, including some percussive sounds obtained by blowing a piece of toilet paper through a comb. All was treated with abundant tape echo and placed on the record. And this, I'm afraid, puts an end to this episode of What A Fab Day. That's it, ciao for now! No, I was just kidding. I have to remind you to please visit www.simonmas.com/support to find ways to support my music-related endeavors. If you like the content, that is. If not, make sure to drop me a line and tell me how I can get better. See you tomorrow for a bonanza of live performances. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.